Burnett out front tonight, President Donald Trump between a wall and a hard place. With a government shutdown looming in the final countdown to his 100-day marker, it all comes down to the wall. Will Trump shut down the government if Democrats refuse to fund his border wall? If you listen to Trump's Homeland Security Secretary John Kelly, the answer to that question is yes.
The president has been pretty straightforward about his desire and the need for a border wall. So I would suspect he'll do the right thing for sure, but I will suspect he will be insistent on the funding.
Insistent on the funding. Democrats, though, say they will not play ball. The Democratic leader in the Senate, Chuck Schumer, calls the wall, quote, a pointless waste of taxpayer money. And today, on that point, taxpayer funded, this simple but important question from our Jim Acosta.
John, on the wall, why is there even a discussion about shutting down the government over paying for the wall? Isn't Mexico supposed to pay for the wall?
Well, I think, Jim, the president has made very clear that initially we needed to get the funding going, and there's be several mechanisms to make sure that that happens. That funding piece will happen in due time. Alexis.
That is a promise that the president made during the campaign.
It is. No, no, but he also
said Mexico would pay for the wall.
Right.
And now we're having a discussion that might shut down over the wall.
Who's
going to pay for it?
Right.
Now, the president himself then went, of course, on Twitter to say that Mexico will pay, but he put an important caveat on it, and here he is. Eventually, but at a later date, so we can get started early. Mexico will be paying in some form for the badly needed border wall. Okay, what this means right now is that we, the taxpayers, are paying for the wall if Democrats approve the funding. And the bottom line is that a taxpayer-funded wall is a broken promise.
We will build a great wall along the southern border, and Mexico will pay for the wall. Mexico is going to pay for the wall.
The American people will not pay for the wall.
Except for we are going to pay for the wall. The wall showdown happening as the president tries to produce a major accomplishment before his 100th day in office. Jason Carroll begins our coverage out front at the White House. And Jason, when it comes to this wall, we're on the verge of a nasty battle.
Battle indeed. When you consider, you've heard it repeatedly, the president saying that Mexico will pay for the wall and that U.S. taxpayers will get reimbursed for it eventually. Democrats not believing that, saying that U.S. taxpayers are going to get hit with this bill. That's why you've got the White House working behind the scenes, trying to work with the House, trying to work with the Senate, trying to get some sort of deal made. Having said that, White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer says at the end of the day, he believes a deal will be reached and a government shutdown will be avoided.
As President Trump closes in on 100 days in office, his administration is setting up a showdown over funding for a border wall.
The president's priorities have been very clear from the beginning.
The president tweeting today, the wall is a very important tool in stopping drugs from pouring into our country and poisoning our youth. And many others. Congress has until Friday to approve a spending bill and avoid a government shutdown. The administration is pushing to include $1.4 billion for the wall as part of that measure.
It will be up to Congress to pass it. And if the Democrats filibuster that and block it, they're the ones shutting the whole government down just to keep the wall from being built.
Democrats say funding for the wall is a non-starter.
To think that he would consider shutting down the government of the United States of America over this outlandish proposal of a border wall, which we can't even pay for at this point, and is opposed by Democrats and Republicans all along the border, that would be the height of irresponsibility.
Even some Republicans on the Hill are suggesting the party cannot risk a shutdown over the wall.
The last thing we can afford is to send a message to the world that the United States government, by the way, is only partially functioning.
White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer today sounded an optimistic note about the prospects for a deal.
We feel very confident that they understand the president's priorities and that we'll come to an agreement by the end of Friday.
On day 95 of his presidency, the president finds himself with the lowest approval ratings at this stage for any president since 1945. Yet a Washington Post ABC News poll finds that 96% of Trump supporters stand by their vote. The White House is aiming to show progress on a number of fronts this week, with the president teasing an announcement Wednesday on tax reform. An administration official telling CNN that lowering the corporate tax rate from 35% to 15%, as Trump promised during the campaign, is under consideration. The White House also rolling out a list of 100-day accomplishments, though many are the result of executive actions taken by the president.
But I don't think there's any question that the president has done a significant amount for the American people on the issues that he has put forward during the campaign.
And a little bit more about that corporate tax rate cut and how that's going to be paid for. Treasury Secretary says that will be paid for through economic expansion. A little bit more about the president and what he's going to be up to tonight. He is going to be meeting with Senators John McCain and Lindsey Graham, two people, as you know, Aaron, who have been very critical of the president during the past. But when you're a president trying to get so much approved before this 100-day mark, you need all the support you can get.
All right. Aaron. Thank you, Jason. And I want to go out front now to Democratic Senator Chris Van Hollen, chairman of the Democratic Senatorial Campaign Committee and a member of the Budget and Ranking Committees. All of this obviously right in the center of